plummeting to certain death needs to be a bad thing.
Welcome.
Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 movie scenes where villains fall to their deaths.
What? What are you talking about?
For this list, we've looked at all movies where the bad guy takes a tumble and then dies. Live action and animated films qualify for this one, but only the biggest bad guys and the best falls get selected. Oh, and you can be sure there are spoilers ahead, so spoiler alert.
You can't afford to take the risk.
Number 10, Shang Tsung, Mortal Kombat.
I am the chosen one.
At 10, there's two realms, Earth and Outworld.
So, this is Outworld, huh? Well, I can see why they want to change the scenery.
The courageous Liu Kang is on our side.
I am Liu Kang, descendant of Kung Lao. I challenge you to Mortal Kombat.
While the malevolent Shang Tsung is the brains behind the baddies.
Shang Tsung, at your service.
When the two meet upon a ledge that overlooks lots of lethal weaponry, it's clear that this scene's gonna end uncomfortably for someone.
Save your pity for the weak.
Thankfully for mankind, and for the continuation of Mortal Kombat, it's Shang Tsung who finds himself skewered through the heart, impaled by his own evil. Number 9. Krug, Star Trek III, The Search for Spock.
If we don't help each other, we'll die here!
Perfect!
The planet all around them is destroying itself, but Krug has eyes only for Kirk, and ears only for the secrets of Genesis.
Genesis! I want it!
The Klingon leader isn't much of a looker, but he is beginning to really get on William Shatner's nerves.
Give me Genesis!
The pair finds themselves precariously positioned on a not-so-steady slither of a rock face, and hand-to-hand combat ensues. As vertigo flickers across the face of the villain, determination drives Kirk's boot into Krug's face. The rest is free-falling, fiery history.
I have had enough of you!
Number 8, Mama, Dread.
And as for you, Mama, judgment time.
In our next movie, slow-mo is a dangerous new drug. And in our next scene, it's not difficult to see why it's so addictive.
Slow-mo?
You only just hit the grid, but it's making big waves. Makes the brain feel as if time is passing at 1% its normal speed.
Madeline Madrigal, or Mama, is the leader of a callous cartel operating out of a dystopic tower block.
I'd kill you myself, but I already lost plenty today. I can't afford to lose more.
When Judge Dredd catches up with her, though, she's caught between the proverbial rock and hard place.
How do you plead?
In this instance, however, the hard place is several stories southward.
Defense noted.
The glass looks like glitter, but the blood's barefaced and brutal. We want to look away, but just can't. Number 7, Gaston, Beauty and the Beast.
Come on out and fight!
Disney villains have a habit of falling to their deaths, but this guy's grisly end is especially memorable.
Hell is mine!
The Beast looks set to throw his rival into the abyss, but in a moment of mercy, Gaston's life is given back to him.
Get out.
Next, and upon seeing Belle, the Beast's heart shines out from its hairy, scary, ferocious form.
You came back.
But Gaston's hatred rears its ugly head again. After some literal backstabbing, the baddie meets his moralistic comeuppance, and the hunter becomes the prey. Number 6, Gollum, The Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King. It takes one ring to rule them all, and one fall to end this epic tale. Gollum was a hobbit once.
Precious.
But so consumed by greed has he become, he meets his end alongside Middle-earth's most valuable item of jewelry. The slow motion, the soundtrack, the scary look in Sméagol's eye. In this scene, the Shire seems a very long way away. Lava never makes an especially soft landing, but the fires of Mount Doom are especially fierce. Number 5, Mola Ram, Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom.
Prepare to meet Kali in hell.
As if dangling from a severed rope bridge above alligator-infested waters couldn't get any worse, Indy has to do it alongside the bloodthirsty high priest Mola Ram. Luckily for Mr. Jones, however, he's in the know when it comes to the necessary incantations for such a situation.
You've betrayed Shiva.
A few choice words. A few red-hot Sankara stones. One desperate grasp at the goods, and one serious slip from safety. Mola Ram's mortality was realized really rather quickly. Number 4, the Joker, Batman.
Feel free to drop in.
Batman might be used to hanging from hard-to-reach places. But the Joker's not quite as adept.
What are you laughing at?
Jack Nicholson has one-lined his way to a helicopter rescue, but the caped crusader isn't about to let the villain fly to safety. The hero's sharpshooting ties the Joker to the gargoyle. The helicopter's power breaks the stone from the church. The gargoyle's weight pulls the Joker to his death. And the sickly, scary smile never leaves the crazy clown's face. It's creepy poetry in menacing motion. Number 3, Alec Trevelyan, Goldeneye.
You know, James, I was always better.
Why can't 007 ever pick a fight in a safe environment? At number 3, he and Sean Bean are stuck atop a tower, and floor space is at a minimum. As Bond battles for an advantage against his one-time friend, various shots showcasing height are nausea-inducing edge-of-seat cinema. Various kicks, headbutts, and strangleholds have all nails bitten and all toes curled. Bean as Alec Trevelyan is the MI6 agent gone wildly astray, but there's still a little in us that expects Bond to spare him.
For England, James?
How wrong we were.
No. For me.
Number 2, Emperor Palpatine, Star Wars Episode 6, Return of the Jedi.
So be it, Jedi.
There are some serious, serious issues in the Skywalker family, and most of them come to a head in this scene.
Your thoughts betray you, Father. I feel the good in you, the conflict.
Luke just will not turn to the dark side, no matter how forcibly his incredibly estranged father tries to make him do so.
You underestimate the power of the dark side.
For Emperor Palpatine, electro-torture is the only answer, and Luke looks certain to be killed.
Race for your lack of vision.
It's Palpatine, though, that soon shall be plummeting to his own death. Vader does it, and in the most roundabout of ways, redeems himself. Before we unveil our top pick, here are a few honorable mentions. Number 1, Hans Gruber, Die Hard.
This is Hans Gruber.
Falling into first place is Alan Rickman with the most magical, menacing, oddly melancholic exit from the top floor of a skyscraper that's ever been filmed.
Put down the gun.
As Hans Gruber, Rickman is the villain that we all secretly root for.
Well, this time John Wayne does not walk off into the sunset with Grace Kelly.
That's why it's weirdly sad when we're given a point of view shot of the charismatic kidnapper breathing his last.
Yippee-ki-yay, mother f***.
The switch between slow motion and real time is real class, and the comic timing by the cops is spot on.
Well, I hope that's not a hostage.
In this instance, Die Hard is a very literal thing. Do you agree with our list? Which fall did we forget?
No, we're not done here!
For more Drop Dead Top 10s published every day, be sure to subscribe to WatchMojo.com.
Yeah, oh, Ninja.